Good morning students, welcome to online class. Today I am going to explain page number 11, do this. Yesterday I already completed page number 10, do this. Okay. What is given means, write the following rational numbers. In the form of P by Q, where Q is of the form 2 power n, 5 power m, where n and m are non-negative integers and then write the numbers in their decimal form. This is the sum is given. The first sum is 3/4. Write the following rational numbers. This is the rational numbers in the form of P by Q. So P by Q. Okay, right. Where Q is of the form 2 power n, 5 power m. So this denominator, Q means in the denominator, 3 by Q. Q can written as 2 powers or 5 powers or 2 into 5, both the 2 powers. So 4 can written as 2 square. Okay. Okay. Where n and m are non-negative integers. Non-negative integers means positive numbers. So 2 is the positive number. Power n. Power n is also positive number. Okay. Here okay, clear. Then write the numbers in the decimal form. This fraction can be converted into decimal form. How to convert the decimal form without division? Okay. Okay, look at the board. Here, multiply both numerator and denominator with what is the power of 2? 2. So, 5 square by 5 square. Both powers are same, equal, you write like that. Okay. 3 into 5 square, 25, by 2 into 5, whole square. It is in the form of a power m into b power m. Both powers are same. Denominators multiplied. A power m into b power m equals to a into b whole power m. You write like this. Okay. 3 25s. 75 by 2 5s, 10. 10 square, 100. So, already know that here in the denominator 2 zeros are there. The decimal point before, after 2 digits. That means 1257.0. So, this is the decimal form of 3/4. And the second one is, what is the second one? 7/25. It is also same. 7/25 can written as 5 square. Either 2 power n or 5 power m form. Okay. Here is also, here 5 square. So, 5 there and write the 2 powers. So, here highest is 2. So, 2 square by 2 square. If you multiplied and both numerator and denominator with the same number, the number cannot be changed their values. So, 7 into 2 square, 4 by 5 into 2 whole square. 7 4 jar, 28/5 to 10² = 100. Equals to t is also 2 zeros are there, so 2 decimal points. Take the decimal point 8.20. So 7/25 is a rational number. This can be converted into decimal form. Third one. 51/64 can written as 2^6. 2^6. So here multiply with 5^6/5^6. Same 2 and 5 both you need. Powers same. You write like this. Okay. 51 × 5/6. 5 × 5 × 5 × 5 × 5 × 5. 6 times. 5 × 5 = 25. 25 × 5 = 6 × 5 = 6 × 5 = 3025 × 6 × 5 × 2 6 × 5 × 5 5 × 5 = 2 5 × 2 = 10 + 2 = 12 1 5 × 6 = 30 30 + 1 = 31 3125 × 5 15625. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 5/6 equals to 15625 by 2 × 5^6. It is in the form of a^m × b^m. So a × b^m. So 2 × 5 = 6. 51 × 15625. × 51 1 table. 1 5 = 5 1 2 = 2 1 6 = 6 1 5 = 5 1 1 = 1. First digit level. 5 table. 5 5 = 25 2 5 2 = 10 10 + 2 = 12 1 5 6 = 30 + 1 = 31 3 5 5 = 25 + 3 = 28 2 5 1 = 5 + 2 = 7 5, 7, 8, 6, 9, 7. So $7,96,875 by 5 × 10 10^6. 1 beside 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So here denominator 6 zeros is there. Then the decimal point. So after 6 digits. 1 from right to left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 5, 7, 2, 8, 3, 6, 4, 9, 5, 7, 6. After 7 digits. 6 digits. 0.796875. This is the decimal form. Next, fourth one. 14/25. Fourth one. 14/25 can written as 5² simply. Into 2² by 2². 14 × 2² = 4. 5 × 2 × 5 = 5 × 2² 14 × 4 = 56 by 100. 5 × 2 = 10. 10² = 100. So here 2 zeros are in the denominator. So before 2 digits. 0.056. Next, fifth one. 80/100. Here it is the directly gave by 100. So after two, before two digits, 12.0.80, or simply cancelled 8 by 10, it is also right 0.8. Okay, 0.80000 is also equals to 0.8. After last digit is zeros, our number of zeros is there is no value. So this is the value of 0.8 only. This is the page number 11. Do this. Okay. Next, example 5. Using the theorems without actual division, state whether the following rational numbers are terminating or non-terminating repeating decimals. First one, 16 by 25. 16 by 125. Is it a terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal? Every rational number is either terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimals only. So here 16 by 125 is given without actual division. Which it is terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal? How to solve this one? Okay, once look at the board. 16 by 125 can written as, how to write the 125? It is in the power of 5 cube. So, every rational number in the denominator, can be written as P by Q form. Where Q is in the form of either 2 power N or 5 power m or both 2 power n into 5 power m. Is formula like you write the in the denominator, it is a terminating decimal. Otherwise, it is a non-terminating repeating decimal. So, it is 125 in written as 5 cube. It is in the form of 5 power m. So, it is terminating decimal. If there is any other number is there, it is a non-terminating repeating decimal. For example, second one. Another one. 25 by 32. You need not be numerator. Only you write only denominator only. 32. 32 can written as 2 power 5. So it is also in the form of 2 power n form. So, it is also a, it is terminating decimal. Which number the denominator can be written in the form of 2 power n or 5 power n or 2 power n into 5 power n form? That is terminating decimal only. Other any number is there, it is a non-terminating decimal. Okay, third one. 81 can written as 3 to the power of 4. It is also in the power of only, but here there is no 2 power n or there is no 5 power n or both. Here another number is there, 3 power something. But here we need 2 power n form or 5 power m form. But here 3 is there. So it is non-terminating repeating decimal or recurring decimal. Okay, the next one is fourth one. 41 by 75 can written as 2 into 3 into 5 square. 5 square means 25 25 3 75. So 3 into 5 square. According to our definition, only 2 power n or only 5 power n or both 2 power n into 5 power m form is there, that is terminating decimal. But here 3 is there, 5 okay, but 3 is there. So it is also, it is non-terminating recurring decimal. Repeating or the recurring, both are same. This is the example 5. Now example 6. Okay, thank you. Tomorrow we will discuss about example 6.